How do I pick the right tools to protect windows? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. An interesting question I got some time ago, let's go through it. Protection against viruses, spam, spyware, etc., 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 is becoming even more critical as time goes by. I'm uncomfortable in relying solely on Microsoft products and technology for protection, but the number of products out there today claiming to be able to provide same seems to be expanding exponentially. So, one, what criteria aside from price could or should you use in making one's decision in security protection selection? Two, would a bundled application, all defenses in one, be necessarily more effective than several standalone products? And three, finally, is there some location on the web where one could find truly valid, independent assessments and reviews of products out there today? These are all really good questions, and the answer to them has changed, in some cases, fairly dramatically over time. Let me go through what I think is important in each of these cases, and I'm going to start by answering your questions in reverse order. Is there some location? This is the answer that's changed fairly dramatically. There used to be really good, I would call them review sites. And there may still be out there. The problem is that so many of them were so successful that the manufacturers of various security software and other software went out and created their own comparison sites. Now, I have to say, quote unquote, comparison sites, because in reality, what they were doing is they would set up a site that looks like a side-by-side objective comparison of multiple different products, but their product would always win. In other words, if you're out looking for, you know, such and such comparison or best such and such, these sites would show up and you would have no way to know whether or not they were truly objective. They would show you a list and pretend to be an objective comparison when they were anything but. Now, I'm a huge, huge believer in reputation, but I no longer believe that there are indeed sites that will do true head-to-head comparison in an objective way that you can find easily. They may be out there. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying they don't exist. I'm just saying that they're difficult to find and hard to distinguish from the ones that have bias. My recommendation then instead is that over time, you develop a level of trust with what I'll call more general purpose sites. I'll use askleo as an example, and I hope that you do develop that trust with my site. But regardless, there are independent sites answering questions or independent support forums that are helping people help one another. And one of the things you'll find on most of those sites are opinions. And lots of them. And that's exactly what you're looking for. But rather than having this wonderful side-by-side, easy-to-digest comparison of the various products you're thinking of, you'll have a set of opinions that you will then have to kind of chew through and understand and decide whether or not the opinions, especially if they're out of balance, but even if they're not, see what it is about those opinions that actually matters to you, whether or not that opinion affects something that you care about. And as a result, you will develop some very good senses for what the current state of security software is. As an example, I won't use security software. I will use actually password vaults. I use LastPass. I think you know that by now. In talking about LastPass, and of course, in talking about LastPass's issues over the past year or so, there have been a number of comments on my site and a number of people have recommended Bitwarden. Great. I now have a really good sense, not just on the positive comments, but on the number of positive comments that I feel comfortable experimenting with and potentially even recommending Bitwarden because of the positive feedback I've seen in other places. I did not go to a head-to-head comparison site. I simply looked at what people were saying. In all of the other places, people say things. Would a bundled application, all defenses in one, be better? Years ago, the answer was a very, very strong, absolutely not. Old security suites were usually one really good product with a bunch of others tacked on to fill in checkboxes. Today, that's actually not the case. Today, most of the security products you'll get are in fact bundles of multiple tools, all packaged into one, that essentially try and solve all of the problems at once. they've matured to a point where, yeah, they work well. The one that I recommend, you probably already have. I know that in your question, you've been avoiding Microsoft solutions, but if you actually take a look at my recommendations for what to use, what's built into Windows these days is in fact my go-to solution. You don't necessarily need to get a third-party solution for antivirus, anti-spyware, firewall, all that kind of stuff. It's all there in Windows, and it works pretty well. If you feel otherwise, then sure, there are security suites that will replace what's in Windows, and that's fine. The fact that it's a suite, not as much of an issue as it used to be. What criteria, aside from price, could or should you use? Honestly, to me, it's all about reputation. That thing we started with, looking around and seeing what people are saying about the tools you're considering investing in. Whether they're free tools and you're just investing time, or they're paid tools and you're actually going to be investing some money, the reputation across the board is probably the single most important factor that you need to consider when you're evaluating various solutions. Now, I get reputation can be hard. You can get it from individuals you trust. It's very easy to look at comments or rating sites or even feedback on places like Amazon where you might purchase something. Yeah, those can all be gamed. That's one of the problems. Reputation can be very difficult to establish. But if you spend enough time in open forums, comment sections, and so forth, still, you will build that sense of reputation. And don't feel afraid to ask a question in an appropriate forum. What do people think about this security solution? You will get some people that will support you. You will get some people that disagree vehemently with your choice. And you'll get a lot of people in between. The point is, you'll get a very good sense of exactly what the masses are thinking about that particular solution right now. Ultimately, it boils down to do the research. I hate to use that phrase these days, but it really does boil down to doing the research in some non-obvious places. Head-to-head comparisons just aren't the places I trust anymore. I actually trust the crowdsourced opinions of various comment sections or independent individuals, askleo and others, who have developed an opinion, who basically have taken a look at some of the tools themselves. Ultimate answer to your question is, in my article, what security software do you recommend? That's the one where I fundamentally recommend what's built into Windows already. The most important article I have covering your online safety is Internet Safety, 7 Steps to Keeping Your Computer Safe on the Internet. That covers things like security software, firewalls, and more. And ultimately, something that we haven't touched on with any of this, and yet it's perhaps one of the most important aspects to your overall security, independent of the software you use, is covered in my article, It Pays to Be Skeptical. So true. I hope that's helpful. For comments, for updates, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/3224. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.